back in Shanghai and settling back down into life in the city. Before I go back to work, I wanted to meet up with some friends, so my first stop was to meet my darling friend Eva for a nice coffee date and to hang out in one of the most popular streets in Shanghai.
Maybe our lives were not meant to collide from the start, but who could foresee the fall? Maybe it's time to decide what to do with the fact that it happens to us all.
After checking out the beautiful stores along this street, Eva and I decided to go somewhere to sit down and have a drink. Neither of us fancied coffee, so we settled for juice instead.
I got apple juice.
Some photographer just stopped us and wants to take our photos, and apparently he's famous. So
show you guys
later.
By this time we'd worked up quite the appetite, so we headed to Almentari to have a little lunch. Eva had some incredible pancakes, which, oh, you've got to get them.
Building bridges slowly, tearing them down fast to start over. We're all trying to come on.
We are in Almentari. I've just got myself. Yeah, look at these pancakes. So beautiful. And then I got a mozzarella and cheese, mozzarella and tomato pesto sandwich. Smells really good, and I'm really hungry. Today is an incredibly rainy, horrible day here in Shanghai, but I'm still going out, braving the weather, and yeah, gonna check out some cafes and maybe see the fake market. I haven't been there, but it's about 2 hours from where we live now, so I'm setting off early. In the rain, got my body, yeah, hoping not to get too wet.
The fake market can be found in the metro station near the Science and Technology Museum on Line 2. It's popular with tourists looking for fake brands and trinkets, but be ready to haggle. I'd suggest starting your price at 10% of what they're selling for and haggle from there. Don't be afraid to walk away empty-handed. They will likely give in, but if they don't, you'll probably find the thing in the next shop anyway. Most of the items can be found on Taobao at a fraction of the price, but where's the fun in that?
So we are at the fake market in the metro station. Hello, Rachel. Rachel, how are you finding it?
An experience. There's a lot going on. Being harassed?
Yeah, at the beginning there was a woman who like followed us around for ages and grabbed our arms and like, just leave us alone.
After the fake market, we headed to Qianzifang. I've shown this on my channel before, but it's such a beautiful area where when it rains, the old streets just look impeccable. This isn't actually old. It was constructed in 1998 from residential housing, but the vibe of the place is, somewhere you just have to visit. You can find this at Dapu Chiao Station, which is line 9. Once the weather had improved, I headed into East Nanjing Road, the longest shopping street in Shanghai, where I was going to meet Melissa and her family.
When I saw you walking down that hill, head high and shoulders back, watching you was such a thrill. All that I
East Nanjing Road, we headed to Shenyang Road near South Shanxi to try and find a cafe. Unfortunately, all of the cafes we planned to go to were closed, so I would guess they're probably knocking down the buildings to build up and build apartment blocks rather than the old style here in the former French concession area.
Out with Melissa, I finally found the book that I've been looking for probably a year, if not longer, and I thought you might like it, so I thought I'd share it with you today, and that is The Shanghai Ren. So this book is in the style of The New Yorker. Again, they have this type of magazine in Tokyo, Paris, and it's loosely based off of the New Yorker style magazine. And it's a compilation of all the covers of the Shanghai editions. So it's just full of beautiful artwork by local Chinese artists. And every single piece is a complete work of art. I will show you a quick flick through of some of my favorites, but these are incredible to have on display, or, you know, they also make posters of them. But as you can see, here is the Shanghai skyline and little things that make Shanghai, Shanghai. It is an absolute masterpiece, and these artists are immensely talented. Look at this. So this is by an artist called Hao Hao. You can read up on the artist here and maybe what inspired the paintings.
and they are in English and Chinese. So, oh, just beautiful pieces of art. And I'm so glad I finally got my hands on it. It was on the pricier side. This is 268 RMB, which is around £30. But for the artwork you get, it's a really good price. And since I spent so much money in the shopkeeper also let me choose 15 alcohol markers for free because they were obviously doing a promotion, which I didn't realize. But yeah, this was found in one of the little bookstores on Fuzhou Road, near East Nanjing Road. So yeah, there are some beautiful bookshops there. You're not really allowed to film in them, so I never have much content. But yeah, if you're into art, there are some art stores down there as well. It is a wonderful street for book lovers and people looking for something to remind them of Shanghai that's really special. The artists are Chinese, some are by other local artists, but there's always a description of what inspired the paintings as well. Just incredible. Watching, don't forget to like, subscribe and comment. Let me know what you'd like me to film next whilst I'm in Shanghai.